Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And to prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries, let us acknowledge our sins and ask for God's mercy and forgiveness. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I've done and in what I've failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me, the Lord our God. May the Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. We may merit to attain eternal life. Grant this prayer through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the book of Ecclesiastes. Vanity of vanities, says Koheleth. Vanity of vanities, all things are vanity. What profit has a man from all the labor which he toils at under the sun? One generation passes and another comes, but the world forever stays. The sun rises and the sun goes down, then it presses on to the place where it rises. Blowing now toward the south, then toward the north, the wind turns again and again, resuming its rounds. All rivers go to the sea, yet never does the sea become full. To the place where they go, the rivers keep going. All speech is labored. There is nothing one can say. The eye is not satisfied with seeing, nor is the ear satisfied with hearing. What has been, that will be. What has been done, that will be done. Nothing is new under the sun. Even the thing of which we say, see, this is new, has already existed in the ages that preceded us. There is no remembrance of the men of old, nor of those to come will there be any remembrance among those who come after them. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
In every age, O Lord, you have been
yesterday, now that it is past, or as a watch in the night.
In every age, O Lord, you have been our refuge.
You make an end of them in their sleep. The next morning they are like the changing grass, which at dawn springs up anew, but by evening wilts and fades.
In every age, in our refuge.
Teach us to number our days aright, that we may gain wisdom of heart. Return, O Lord, how long? Have pity on your servants.
In every day, O Lord, you have been our refuge.
Fill us at daybreak with your kindness, that we may shout for joy and gladness all our days. Prosper the work of our hands for us. Prosper the work of our hands.
In every day, O Lord, you have been our refuge.
Because some were saying, John has been raised from the dead. Others were saying, Elijah has appeared. Still others, one of the ancient prophets has arisen. But Herod said, John I beheaded. Who then is this about whom I hear such things? And he kept trying to see him. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Christ.
The first reading that we have heard from Ecclesiastes was written by a writer called Kohelet, and some say he was writing out of frustration because he said all is vanity in our lives, all is vanity. But there's a teaching from that. Of course, for the little children, life sometimes seems just the same every day. But for us adults, life is different every day. It brings different challenges, and it brings joy, it brings sadness, it just changes. And when we look at that, there are moments when we feel like this writer felt. We feel like all is vanity. Sometimes we ask ourselves, why am I doing this? Why am I working? Why am I here? You know, those kind of questions. But you know, life was meant to be good life. Because when God created everything, he saw that it was very good, including our life. And that is, should be our focus, that life is good. And we have to make the best out of it. No matter what challenges we face in life, we have to find a meaning in this life. We have to find a meaning even in those challenges. Yes, I think there's a lesson from saying all is vanity. I think the lesson for me, and maybe some of you, will be that we cannot just hold on to the material world so much, because one day it will pass away. So what this writer is saying to us is there's something more beyond our life, and that is God himself. Our Lord Jesus Christ must have the meaning above anything else in life. That is Christianity. Of course, God has given us all that we have, including our lives, and we have to enjoy it, and we have to make, like I said, the best of it. But we should not be possessed by the material world. We have to look beyond the material world, because it's true, whether we are rich or poor, one day everything will remain behind and will go. Like he said, everything will pass away. Everything remains the same. We go generation after generation. If we can have that in mind, that does not take away our joy about life, but just to be aware that God means so much in our lives. And Jesus Christ has presented himself to us. And we always have to look forward to have that wonderful relationship with our Lord Jesus Christ. We have heard King Herod, who beheaded John the Baptist. He was seeking to see Jesus. And when he met him, as we know in the scripture reading, it was almost when Jesus was about to die. Then he saw him, and I think he didn't see what he was expecting. But you and I, we see so much in our Lord Jesus Christ, and we hear so much. And Jesus Christ is telling us, yes, you can enjoy this life, but at the same time, do not forget your Creator. That's the meaning of all is vanity. One day we are going to leave Mother Earth. So always, in whatever we are doing, whatever we are saying, in all our lives, Jesus Christ and God our Father must be above anything else in our lives. Let us now stand and present our prayers to the Lord. For those who feel discouraged about life, that they may come to see and experience it differently and be filled with hope, we pray to the Lord. For those who are despairing of life's meaning, that there will be for them today an experience of goodness and beauty which lifts their spirit and gives them hope, we pray to the Lord. For each one of us, that we may feel the care of Mary our Mother, and with the grace of Jesus, be people of mercy in our care of the poor and in our relationships, we pray to the Lord. That all Christians and good people may hear the cry of the poor and gladly and generously come to their aid, we pray to the Lord. For the many burdens of life which spurs us today, to pray for those who feel depressed and discouraged, we pray to the Lord. Lord our God, in the shortness of our lives, give us wisdom of heart so that we can rejoice in our life. We make all these prayers through Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink. Blessed be God. Pray, my dear sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the cause of Jesus Christ.
Receive with favor, O Lord, we pray, the offerings of your people, that what they profess with devotion and faith may be theirs through these heavenly mysteries, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And
lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is
truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For just as through your beloved Son, You created the human race, so also through him, with great goodness, you formed it anew. And so it is right that all your creatures save you, and all the redeemed praise you, and all your saints with one heart bless you. Therefore we too extol you with all the angels, as in joyful celebration we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord,
of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring out the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and Robert our Bishop and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us, O we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostle and Glorious Martyr, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Jesus taught us to call God as our Father, and so we have the courage to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Gracious, grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, power, and glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
All the time.
he was there all the time, waiting patiently in line. He was there
your redemption, both in mystery and in the manner of our life, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with
your spirit. May the Almighty God bless you, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth in the love and peace of Christ. The Mass is ended.
Thanks be to God.
We end this Mass by saying, yes, Jesus loves me.
Jesus loves me, yes, I know.
Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me.